and sounds of Cultura, SOC, the latest Child's Play production on stage is set to make its world premiere later this month. The Sun Serpent is a multimedia production featuring masks by Arizona master mask maker Zarco Guerrero, music by composer Daniel Valdez, and the work of playwright Jose Cruz Gonzalez. With me to talk about this is director Rachel Bowditch, assistant professor at the Herberger Institute for Design and the Arts at ASU. Rachel, welcome to Horizonte.
Thank you.
This is an exciting production, and mm-hmm. part of it is just this all-star group that mm-hmm. you've put together, including you. Mm-hmm. Tell us how that came to be.
The project came about 2 years ago. Jose Cruz Gonzalez has been working closely with Child's Play for many years, and this has been a dream project of his, how to tell the story of the conquest of Mexico through the eyes of a young boy. And he approached David Saar with this project.
David Saar is with Child's Play.
Yeah, he's the artistic director of Child's Play. And so he approached David Saar with this project, and David Saar, who's familiar with my work as a director, it's very physical and visual, brought me on the project. So it was the three of us, and Jose then brought on Daniel Valdez to do the original sound score for the entire show.
Which is quite a coup. I mean, he's very famous.
Yeah, he's incredible. His music is fantastic. I can't wait for people to hear it. We're actually, it's incredible. We're using indigenous instruments, and he's done incredible research into what the sounds were, combining Spanish and Aztec throughout the whole show. One thing that Jose and David knew from the beginning is they only wanted to have three actors. So my challenge was, how do you tell the story of the conquest of Mexico with three actors? We worked with puppets and miniatures, and we did all sorts of explorations. We had three different devising sessions working with a Child's Play company. And we discovered early on that the most expressive mode was masks.
And that's where Zarco
came in. And then we invited Zarco on board, and he seemed like a perfect fit because he's been making masks for 30 years, and his masks are incredibly beautiful.
World famous.
Yes.
He's been on our show several times.
Incredible yeah. stuff. So we decided that we were going to tell this story with three actors using 30 masks, 30 characters. And I've been working with Zarco for the last 6 months, visiting him at his studio, working with the costume designer, Connie Furr, to really create what these masks and these different characters are.
And I want to talk about the characters and the development of the yeah. story. We do have a picture of at least one of the early conceptions of the mm-hmm. background setting
okay.
for this that we're going to put up on the monitor in a second.
Okay.
And there it is now. Tell us, and I realize this has changed a little bit in terms of where we are now, but
yeah.
give us a description of what the people in the audience will actually be seeing.
So the circular disc is the Aztec calendar, as close to the Aztec calendar as we have found in our research. There are actually only four panels now, and that is those are video projections. They are actually... it's on this fabric called textiline, so we can project onto it as well as use it like a scrim so actors can be behind it to create different surfaces. There will be a rich media projection going through forest scenes and ocean and waterfalls to the city of dreams, to Tenochtitlan, all these different environments. Adam Larson is doing this amazing media design for the show. We have Tim Munson doing the lights. So we have all these designers working together. We wanted to create an open set where we can work with the micro story of the little boy and his family with the macro story of the conquest. So we're shifting back and forth through time and through different sort of historical periods with this intimate story of the boy that we're following through this journey.
And we've got three principal characters.
Three principal
I think
characters.
You mentioned before there are yeah. like 36, but the three principal characters.
So the main story follows a Nahuac, a young Totonac boy, and he's 10.
And we've got a picture on the screen now of the, they're brothers, right? And that's the
Correct.
Grandmother. And
Telememe is the brother. Their parents were killed by the Aztecs. And Ansi is their mother, their grandmother. And so we follow their journey. Cortez makes landfall, and he is mistaken as the Sun Serpent, as Quetzalcoatl, as the person who's coming to save them from the Aztecs. And what happens is Telememe goes, because he's angry that his parents were killed, goes and chooses to join Cortez's army. What ends up happening is Cortez then ransacks villages, Anzi gets killed, and he is forced to go find his brother and to save him from the inevitable as they're marching towards the City of Dreams to meet Montezuma. So it really is a coming-of-age story where we follow the two brothers. They've both taken two paths.
Yeah, they're kind of on different sides of the conflict.
They're two sides of the conflict, and ultimately they meet at the end, and we see how much both of them have changed. And we realize that Diego, Telememe has been renamed Diego, has joined Cortez, and he's become a conquistador, which is what was happening with the native population. They were coerced and co-opted by the Spanish to fight the Aztecs.
The Aztecs had a lot of enemies, and Cortez took advantage
of that. Exactly. And so he was able to gather that steam behind him. Meanwhile, Anahuac is going through this history trying to find his way. And in the end, he becomes adopted by Franciscan monks and becomes a scholar and is the one who records that history through the codices.
So the story goes post-conquest?
It's pre-conquest. But the last moment, without ruining it, is really sort of seeing how memory and through drawings and through oral stories, that's how we remember our past.
Now, we put up some information about the time and everything for the performances. What are people going to, in your opinion, what's the biggest impression they're going to have when they walk out?
We talked about the experience of the audience, that they enter into a world that they're unfamiliar with. So they're going to be hearing Spanish, Nahuatl, English, combined.
So a real multicultural, multimedia.
Absolutely. Event. And we want them to, they'll have a visual, multimedia, saturated environment. It's going to be very physical, very energetic, hopefully entertaining, but at the same time.
And on that note, we're going to have to end. I'm sorry we're out of time, but
no
I'm sure it will be entertaining. Thank you so much
for joining us.
That is our show for tonight. From all of us here at Horizonte, I'm Jose Cardenas. Have a good evening.